My name is James Jimenea, 24 years old, your budding looks candidate number one, representing Bacolod City. My focus in life is environmental awareness. Philippines is having a hard time to cope up with these adverse effects like pollution, mining, poaching, and destruction of wildlife habits. As a fellow citizen of our country, I would like to counter these problems. I would like to provide assistance to counter by doing simple things that may at least lessen the weight of burden experience. I would like to encourage everyone to participate in my advocacy. Change is dependent on the actions brought by many who is pursuing it. Action to help environment includes provision of additional garbage cans for waste disposal, tree planting, environmental codes signboard installation, also manipulating social media to provide information. I believe if all of us would make these relevant actions, the environment would start to heal with a faster progress. Rising awareness of environment is an important advocacy which encourage everyone, all Filipinos, to be as one participating for a change. Protekta ng ating kalikasan para sa kinabukasan ng ating bayan.
Hi, I'm John Lorenzo, 20, your Mr. Body and Looks candidate number 2 from the sweet green city of Victorias.
As a fitness coach and an athlete, my advocacy
is to encourage everyone, especially the youth, to a fitness lifestyle, because some of you, athletes and children, are addicted on drugs, social media, and online games. So that's why we need to encourage our LGU local government unit to have a fitness program, because I believe that fitness is a journey for you tonight.
Jordan Pedres Bautista, your Mr. Badindos Philippines, representing the municipality of Nalbagan, candidate number 3.
A pageant that could influence and boost the self-confidence of every young man. Hi, I am Jordan Pedres Bautista, representing the municipality of Nalbagan, candidate number 3. I am proud to say that I am advocate of this pageant. We all know that this pageant is not only a pageant for men, but also an influence to us to boost our self-confidence in showing our feeling, good body, and looks. We know that there's so many pageants out there, but this pageant is different among others. Why? Because it shows camaraderie, showing the closeness of groups or teammates, which leads to us to become a family. I noticed that every candidate gives a lot of preparation in their physical appearance. Some of us don't have enough good body to show. So, as a fitness coach, I want to inspire and help to improve their body to fit their looks. So question is, how we can help and improve this pageant and helping those aspiring men to achieve the good body and looks. We need to have a good professional trainer to help us candidates to improve our body by providing a free training program in a training center or fitness gym in order to have to gain a good body and looks. Lastly, we have to encourage young men to join this pageant because there's a lot of benefits to gain. Not just about the money, but it's about closeness of every members of this production and also gaining a good body and looks because of training program. Ladies and gentlemen, let us support this pageant. Let us acknowledge the effort of every people behind this pageant. Let us continue to inspire the aspiring young men to continue pursuing their goals in pageant. Cheers for more progressive and productive pageant. Once again, I am Jordan Pedres Bautista, your Mr. Body and Looks Philippines, representing the municipality of Nalbagan, candidate number 3.
Carmelo was the leader for a year, 24. New Canada's number 4 from the city of smiles, the Golden City.
Hi, I'm Carmelo, 24, your candidate number 4 from the city of Smile, Bacolod City. My advocacy is speaking skills improvement for young men and women, and of course, personality development. Because most of the Filipino people believe in the saying that we live in the country, the skin color is a barometer to judge beauty, and of course, speaking English is a barometer to judge intelligence. But in my advocacy, I'm going to change that one. We need to be proud whatever skin color that we have, as long as we influence others in a good way. We need to be consistent for every problem that we are facing. Language barriers is not really important. Whatever language that we are using, whether it can be mother tongue language or English, as long as you are spreading goodness in the community, you're doing good with your fellow men, then it's not really a problem for all of us. I am an advocate of this for almost 3 years. So, I prefer to join in this competition, Mr. Body and Looks Philippines 2020, because I believe that my advocacy was really suited for this kind of pandemic. Because we are all familiar that almost 200,000 cases here in the Philippines of COVID 2019, and of course, almost 24 million cases to the entire world. So, it's really alarming and it's really hit me hard because of this situation. So as one of the candidates, it could be a solid platform for me to have change, even in a small way, because I know to myself that we need to be familiar for everything that we are doing, especially right now. We need to know where to avoid or not to avoid from every places or every single things in life. So ladies and gentlemen, this kind of competition is really important for me, because I will use this one as a voice for me to speak everything that I want to influence in the community. Especially, there's a lot of people which is not really familiar about what they are doing. They're not really informed what will be the proper protocol for this kind of pandemic. So personality development is really important nowadays, because you know what, you can avoid from having a depression, you can avoid from having a mental problem, or whatever problem that they are looking forward to think, if you know how to develop yourself. So this kind of competition is not only looking forward for your physical appearance, how fit you are as a person, but this competition also is all about having an influence with others in a good way. So ladies and gentlemen, my advocacy is all about that. So speaking skills improvement for young men and women. I've been to different kind of events before, so I already have that moment in sharing how to talk properly, how to voice out everything in the crowd. So I'm really familiar with everything in terms of speaking skills. And of course, personality development, you know how to handle yourself, and you know yourself that you can be that influential person from others, and that will make you who you are. So speaking skills improvement for young men and women, and personality development. Thank you so much. God bless to all of you. And this is Carmelo, candidate number 4 from Bacolod City. God bless.
Jimenea, 24 years old, your body looks candidate number one, representing La Galaxy.
is Axel Multivivia, 21, your candidate number 5. And I am proud to represent from the land of the sweet Wind City, Victorious. As one of the contestants of Mr. Baden Looks 2020, my advocacy is the prevention of this COVID-19 pandemic, which for poor people, everybody should be aware of this kind of disease. Volunteering and service are more important during crisis. Social distancing does not mean social isolation. We're in this together, so be a helper. Let's do our part to contribute the common good, so that when this crisis is over, we're proud of how we came together to keep our young people, our communities, and our democracies thriving. Once again, this is Axel Multivivia saying, stay home, stay safe, we heal as one. Once again, thank you, and God bless.
Just only for the people of my barangay, but also to the people of Negros and even to our country, that we youth are the future of our generation. Indeed, youth is the future of our nation, and we should empower them. I'm not here that just only to win this competition, but to educate our young people to avoid any kinds of vices, especially the use of drugs and other hazardous things that may cost their life. but rather to incorporate ourselves in different recreational activities that would strengthen and stabilize our body. We should always put in our minds that our wealth is our health, especially in this time of pandemic. And if we could teach our youth to a positive place, we can have a brighter future ahead, which would bring to say, ang kabataan ay ang pag-asa ng bayan turns into reality. Once again, I am Regent Sandy, from the Municipality of Binalbagan, your Mr. Body News of the Philippines, candidate number 7.
Good day, this is Dixar Diaz, 19, your candidate number 8, who's presenting City Binalagaan Victorias.
Hi, this is Dixar Diaz, 19, your candidate number 8. I'm proud to represent City Binalagaan Victorias. Sa ngayon po, isa lang po ang naisip na tanging advokasya ko. As the title it say, isa lang po ang nais ko ito promote, health and wellness, kalusugan at kagaling, lalo na sa aming kabataan, katulad ko. Isa lang po ang tanging sandata natin sa ngayon na haharap tayo sa COVID-19. Habang buhay na matili na magiging malinis ating katawan, pagsunod sa health protocols, disiplina, pagkain ng wasto, at marami pang iba. Tiyak na tayo magiging tagumpay sa labang habang buhay. With health and wellness comes the body and looks. Thank you and God bless.
Hi, this is Christian Paul Kumag, 21 years of age. You're Mr. Body and Looks Philippines, candidate number 10 from Bacolod City. my advocacy is to raise awareness against HIV/AIDS. Because nowadays, HIV/AIDS is a very rampant and very relevant issue in our society. Which is the only way now to avoid HIV/AIDS is to be faithful and be loyal to your partner. We're in 21st century, where sex is free and love is expensive. That's all for tonight. Thank you.
Candidate number 11, representing Bacolod City.
Hi, this is Bert Paredes Bariang, 26. Your Mr. Badin Looks candidate number 12. Proud to represent Municipality of Hinuban.
Good day, everyone. My name is Bert Paredes Valiao, 26 years old, and I am your Mr. Badin Looks candidate number 12, representing Municipality of Hinuban. Today, I'd like to share to all of you my advocacy. My advocacy is about cyberbullying. We, the youth, and all the people in this modern society are aware that cyberbullying has become an increasingly disturbing phenomenon that has caused insecurities, bumping, depression, and even acts like harm on self. And we teenagers are the most vulnerable to this cruel act. Cyberbullying is an inhumane, intolerable act, and if left unattended, will eventually damage more people and teens like us. However, we, as a cyber teens responsible leaders, can advocate for its eradication. I believe that our advocacy begins with defining our boundaries anchored on the values of respect, empathy, discipline, and compassion. I also believe that such advocacy empowers young people and teens like us in accepting our differences regardless of our physical attributes, economic standing, race, values, even religion. Therefore, we must commit ourselves to be a catalyst on an enlightened youth movement that boldly stand up against cyberbullying, raises awareness our fellow youth on the responsible usage of the information and communication technology, support each program of our government officials, lend voice to those who don't have courage to speak out and seek help. Therefore, we, as a cyber teens responsible leader of this generation, must actively join forces and absolutely say no to cyberbullying. Ladies and gentlemen, I gave you my word. Thank you.
Today, I am Vic Nasataya, 29, your candidate number 13, representing Yudipunggol, Hiligaran.
Good day, I'm Vic Nasataya, 29, your candidate number 13, representing Hinigara. The first step to embark on an effective advocacy for self-confidence is to believe in yourself. Believing in yourself, it means you are aware of your strengths, know that you're worthwhile, and are willing to take good care of yourselves. Many people who have troubling emotional symptoms and we have a disability struggle with self-esteem. to ask for what you need and want to protect yourself when others treat you badly, and you will need to support your self-worth. In the process of advocating for myself, I will keep calm because this increases my effectiveness. In the process of advocating for myself, I am committed to speaking out and respecting the rights of others and listening to what they have to say. Be firm and persistent. Don't give up. Use your self-confidence to achieve your goals in life. And of course, love yourself, because only in loving and appreciating yourself can you see your worth, which eventually exudes in a bright and confident personality to everyone to see. Once again, this is Vic Nasataya representing Hinigaran.
Agbayani, your Mr. Body and Looks candidate number 14, and I'm proud to represent Baguio City.
Care for those ones who care for us is one of the highest honors by Tia Walker. I am raised by a strong woman whom I call my Lola, my great-grandmother who has been there since the very beginning. We all know that the world is aging and so us are. Elderly care provides many free services to seniors such as assistance with medical care, concern, and health insurances also. It is not too late to return the favor and their love to us. We needed them, and now they needed us. I am dedicating this advocacy to all the elders who are the ones who took care for us.
I'm Ryan Vincent Agbayani, your Mr. Body and Looks candidate number 14, and I'm proud to represent Baguio City.
Hi, my name is Dian Carlo Bendo, 21, and proud to represent Bacolod City.
Hi, magandang umaga sa lahat. Ayon sa manunulat at manunula na si Oscar Wilde, ang pinakamainam na paraan para maging bumait ang bata ay pasayahin sila. Paano sila pasasayahin? Ang mga bata ay mahanap ng paraan kagaya ng pakikipaglaro sa mga kaibigan o bagong kaalaman galing sa paaralan. Ngunit lahat hindi nakakatamasa ng ganun dahil sa maagang pagkatrabaho para sa kanilang mga pamilya at kumita ng pera. Ang iba pa rito, nagtatrabaho sa mga delikadong minahan, sa mga bukirin, at siyempre sa kalsada. Napakasakit ng isipin na imbis nag-aral sila at nakikipaglaro sa mga kababata nila, kinakukuha pa nila magutak ng buto para lang kumita ng pera para magpagkain sa pagkainan nila. Napakasakit isipin na imbis na nagsasaya sila ay tinatamasa nila ang trabaho ng pamatanda. Kaya bilang isang bata at binata, aking advokasya ay edukasyon at ang kabataan. Aking hikayatin ang kabataan na sumampa ng paaralan. Dahil ang edukasyon ay tungo sa kaunlaran at ang kabataan ay ang pag-asa ng bayan para may panlaban sa panahon ng kagipitan. Maraming salamat.
Time runs fast. It's been more than a year that I was crowned Mr. Badin Philippines 2019. From that moment, there was a major twist in my outlook on life since I was given this responsibility to promote the good health and well-being of every individual as an advocate of Mr. Badin Philippines 2019. I've been keeping myself busy on how to promote and maintain a healthy and a good form body in order to serve as a role model for the aspiring youth in our society. It has helped me to grow more mature and socially involved in our community as an ambassador of good body for the aspiring candidates of Mr. Badi and Luke's Philippines 2020. Always think that winning a title is not solely gaining popularity. Always think that winning a title is not solely gaining popularity and being famous. Once you get a title, it's the start of your journey of hard work and put into an action of your focuses that would help our society, especially the young individuals. Always think positively every action you will do it to promote the causes each one of you working on. I would like to thank the production head and my president, Larry Mendez, for this rare and great opportunity for me for being one of the title holders with a purpose. Once again, best of luck to all the aspiring candidates and for the lucky title holders, especially to my successor, Mr. Badin Philippines 2020. Be prepared, fasten your seatbelt, and enjoy your journey to the real world of Pageant title holders. I am Edsel Vasquez-Anchi, your reigning Mr. Badin Philippines 2019, signing off.
Greetings everyone, especially to our candidates. I would like to personally congratulate you all for your bravery and sincere efforts to showcase what God gave to you as candidates for Mr. Badin Lux Class Philippines 2020. I could absolutely relate to the battling feeling you are experiencing right now. Since I once doubted myself and fear rejections or disappointments, but God gave me strength as He always does in each of us. It was an unforgettable journey filled with challenges, learnings, and maturity. And I am genuinely happy to share this all with you, as life is meant to be shared and to be truly enjoyed. To the next Mr. Lux Philippines, be a genuine gentleman as a best model of good personality. And everyone, please remember and thank all those who are with you, supported you, and shaped you to become the person who you are tonight or today. Lastly, I thank God so much and everyone for sharing their time for this wonderful event. This is your Mr. Lux Philippines 2019, John David D. Dogma, now signing off.
When I started this journey, I have no idea where it was taking me. Looking back, I thought me believe in myself the way my family and my God believe in me. After all, when I love myself, value myself, and appreciate myself, my cups are overflowing and I'm able to pour into my life around me the way my heart desires. When I started this journey, I had no idea where it was taking me. Looking back, I thought me believe in myself the way my family and my God believe in me. Having won the biggest male pageant in Negros Occidental was not an easy task. The challenges I face are more than making myself well equipped for my future. My journey to Mr. Badin Lux Philippines 2019 has a lot of memories that is indelible to me. maintaining my academic records amidst my parents' expectation for me to graduate with honors and flying colors. That alone was really a very multitasking on my part, but with the support of my friends, family, my mentors, lead family, staff, and the president of this organization, Mr. Larry Medes. Thank you so much for opportunity to Almighty God, I thought all the while that being ambassador of goodwill of this city. I will be assisted with all my vision to push through my advocacy and to bring an impact to my community that I am not just a winner, but a winner with a cause. And mostly, it's a great privilege for me to be part of Lee family, that I was able to continue my vision of not just being a winner, but also pushing through what I want and reaching out to what I can offer in my own simple and little ways. I hope sharing my story behind my success would serve as well as inspiration to all aspiring bachelors who are into male pageants, that no matter how busy you are, as long as your passion, no one can stop you. For success is a matter of being the best and winning the race. Success is a matter of handling in the worst and still finishing with confidence. Samuel Oberas Campus, your reigning Mr. Body and Looks Philippines 2019. Signing off.